Mama couldn't see him, oh, but he was standing there. And I knew in my heart he was the answer to my prayer. Oh, I believe there are angels among us, sent down to us from somewhere up above. They come to you and me in our darkest hours to show us how to live, to teach us how to give, to guide us with the light of love.
So today's talk is Angels Among Us. And tomorrow, as you can tell if you look around, is Halloween, right? So it's a holiday I really like because there's no cooking, and there's lots of candy, and there's lots of costumes en masse. But Halloween isn't the only day that we wear costumes en masse. We wear them every day without realizing it. By the clothes I choose to put on, by the way I wear my hair, if I choose to be clean-shaven or wear a beard, by my words, by my actions. Without realizing it, I wear a mask, I wear a costume so that I fit in, so that I get approval of the people in the world around me. And because I'm not consciously aware that I'm wearing a costume, that I'm wearing a mask, I'm not conscious that others are wearing a mask and a costume. So we walk around in this world, not seeing beyond the costumes and the masks, and we miss something beautiful. We miss that spiritual being just like us, behind that costume, behind that mask. There's a poem by Shel Silverstein called The Mask. She had blue skin, and so did he. He kept it hid, and so did she. They searched for blue their whole life through, then passed right by and never knew. What beautiful soul are you missing the opportunity to meet because you're hiding your blue? You're hiding your true self behind a costume or a mask. No matter our color, our culture, our language, our religious beliefs, under that mask, there's a spiritual being. In unity, we call it our Christ self, the divinity within. And we'll pass by, we'll miss knowing that person because we're keeping our true self, our true blue self, hidden. But when we dare to come out from behind our mask and live from our true self, our words and actions originate from a place deep within us, and we don't even hesitate to reach out a helping hand in kindness, in love, to help someone. The words in the song said, "Angels show us how to live. They teach us how to give." The true story, Marilyn Kinchella. When she was boarding the airplane, she forgot the no liquid rules, and so her liquids were beyond that size, and she was a painter. She was carrying all her paints, and so she had to leave all her paints at security. She came back from her trip a week later, and in baggage claim was an attendant from the airline who had not only saved all her paints for her, but took the time to look up when she was coming back, so he could be there and meet her in luggage and return her paints. Have you ever had a stranger come along and do something nice for you when you didn't expect it? Just think about it real quick. I'm sure every one of you has someone that pops up. Maybe they smiled at you when you were feeling down. Maybe they let you cut into a long line of traffic. Or they opened the door for you when you had your arms full. Angels wear so many faces, and they show up in the strangest places. Zena Hamilton, another true story, tells about when she was 7 years old and her family drove to the Grand Canyon, was driving to the Grand Canyon, and her favorite blankie blew out the window. You know what happens when your kid has a favorite blankie, right? Even at seven. And it was gone. A little later, the family pulled into a service station. And Zena was just moping. She was miserable. And Mom had made sandwiches, so she sat down on a bench outside the service station with her mom, and she hadn't even taken a bite out of the sandwich, and with this motorcycle gang pulled up. And this huge bearded biker gets off his bike, and he walks over to Mom and her, and he looks at her and says, "Is that your blue Ford over there?" And Mom, like, goes, "Yeah." And he reaches in his jacket pocket, and he pulls out Zena's blanket and says, "Is this yours?" And then he turns and walks back to his bike. And Zena, the only thing she could even think to do at 7 years old was jump up, run after him, and give him her sandwich. Angels show up in ways that we may judge as less than angelic. A huge bearded biker dude. A disheveled homeless person. Or a tough-looking guy on a street corner. When I realize I'm judging someone by their costume or mask, I have to stop. I have to take a moment. I have to stop, and I have to remind myself, there's an angel in there. And look deeper. The song tells us that angels come to us during troubled times to light up our way with a ray of hope. Yesterday, I went to the memorial service of Jean Letarte. Jean used to be a member here. She used to click back there for us. Some of you may remember her. And they didn't have it at a church. She had been in AA for years, and she had sponsored many people, so we had it where her AA group met. And as I listened to people get up and talk about Jean, I realized this woman was an angel among so many people. People got up and said, when I was going to give up, she was there. Tough love, telling me things I didn't want to hear, but she helped me through. She'd drive out of her way to pick me up and take me to a meeting. And it went on and on. Geraldine's husband died unexpectedly. Another true story. And every week for a year, a coworker sent her a card. Every week she'd get a card from this coworker saying, just thinking of you. Hang in there. And Geraldine said it saved her life. And that's the stories I heard over and over again about Jean at her memorial service. Have you ever had an angel call you at just the right time? Have you received a card in the mail unexpectedly that maybe brightened up your day when it wasn't such a great day? Or maybe somebody posted something on Facebook just when you needed to see it. We call people who have done incredible things heroes, angels. But a hero or an angel is simply someone who is fully present in the moment. And then they speak and act from that place deep within them. They come from a place of kindness, a place of love, because they're connected to their spiritual being, their spiritual self. Another true story, when Clarence Stevens returned to his car from the store, he found he'd locked his keys and his cell phone in the car. A teenage boy was going by on a bicycle, and he noticed Clarence kick the tire and say a few words. So the kid drove up and he said, "What's wrong?" Clarence said, "Oh, my keys, my cell phone are in there." And the teenage boy said, here, take my cell phone and call your wife. He said, it won't do any good. We've only got one car. And the boy said, I will go to your house and get the keys and bring them back. And Clarence said, that's 7 hours round trip. I'm sorry, 7 miles. 7 miles. Sorry. Got away from my notes over here. 7 miles. Still a long ways, right? So the kid got on his bike and took off and came back an hour later with the keys to the car. Clarence tried to pay him. And the kid said, no, I needed the exercise. And then Clarence said, and just like in the cowboy movies, he just kind of rode off into the sunset. Angels wear many faces. Teenagers, maybe a goofy-looking teacher we had. They show up in the strangest places, don't they? But they grace us in our time of need. There's no ceremonies for them. There's no medals. There's no recognition. They simply show up at the perfect time to brighten our day. There's a video that's been going around for a while, and I just thought it was perfect to share with you today. Deanna, is it ready, or do we need to talk a few more minutes? It's ready. Okay. Turn the lights down, please.
จะได้อะไรถ้าเขาทำแบบนี้ทุกวันจะไม่ได้อะไรเลยไม่ได้รวยขึ้นไม่ได้ออกทีวีไม่มีใครรู้จักไม่ได้มีชื่อเสียงที่มากขึ้นเพราะสิ่งที่เขาได้คือได้แค่ความรู้สึกได้เห็นความสุขได้เข้าใจได้ความรักได้ในสิ่งที่เงินซื้อไม่ได้ได้โลกที่สวยงามกว่าเดิมในชีวิตคุณอะไรคือสิ่งที่คุณต้องการมากที่สุด
ไทยประกันชีวิตเชื่อในความดี
What I love, that it was a totally different culture, wasn't it? And it's the same message. It's the message we try to get around this world. We each have the ability to be an angel to someone. What simple things that showed us we could do. Moving a flower pot under the water. All we have to do is be present, to listen, to look for the call of where we can help. With a kind word, with a simple gesture. A friend once shared with me that they were in the grocery store, and this person just looked so worn and so sad, they just were moved to go over and give them a hug. And the person thanked them profusely and said that it had changed their whole day and maybe their life. And my friend said, you know, it wasn't anything, and I almost didn't do it. There has been a time when you've been moved to do something and didn't do it. Next time, do it. Don't worry what other people think. You noticed in the video, people were shaking their heads as he was being nice. So what? Be nice. Be kind. Be loving. Gandhi told us to be the change we want to see in the world. And we can do that with a simple gesture of kindness. We can change the world. One person at a time. Just by letting them know that they're seen, that they're heard, that they matter, that they're loved. Isn't that what you want? Halloween is about costumes. It's about masks, isn't it? It's about the magic and the mystery. But the costumes and masks that hide our true blue self keep us from the magic and the mystery of the mystical experience of seeing angels among us. So today, I am calling all you angels to take off your masks, live from your true self, so the world can know there are angels among us. God bless you.
Mama couldn't see him, oh, but he was standing there. And I knew in my heart he was the answer to my prayer. Oh, I believe there are angels among us, sent down to us from somewhere up above. They come to you and me in our darkest hours, to show us how to live, to teach us how to give, to guide us with the light of love. I've had troubled times, had me down on my knees. There's always been someone to come along and comfort me. A kind word from a stranger to lend a helping hand. A phone call from a friend just to say I understand. Now ain't it kind of funny, at the dark end of the road, someone lights the way with just a single ray of hope. Oh, I believe there are angels among us, sent down to us from somewhere up above. They come to you and me in our darkest hours, to show us how to live, to teach us how to give, to guide us with the light of love. They wear so many faces, they show up in the strangest places. They grace us with their mercies in our time of need. Oh, I believe there are angels among us, sent down to us from somewhere up above. They come to you and me in our darkest hours, to show us how to live, to teach us how to give, to guide us with the light of love, to guide us with the light of love.